I've got...
Hey guys, it's Snail Mail, and I'm here with Clouded X Marbles.
What's up, guys?
He's the host of our stream. We're going to be doing a game review. This is the first episode in game reviews. We're going to be doing Mafia 3 today. Yeah, so let's just get to it. Let's go. Pros! Okay.
The soundtracks in the game and much more definitely fit the title. Like, most of the time I find myself just driving around listening to tunes. Like, my car can go fast, but time to time I find myself going like 70 down the road just to listen to tunes and not get distracted and crash into stuff.
Yeah, I gotta say it's era appropriate for sure, because it's like, it's all the classics, like Little Less Conversation from Elvis Presley's in there, and that, like, every time that comes on the radio, it's just like, alright, so I'm not doing my mission right now. I'm waiting. I'm gonna let the song finish out. Although, I guess my pet peeve with that is the song cuts off early because it's the 60s version. So, it technically isn't that long, but they have versions these days that are extended. So I'm a little sad about that. But I love the fact that it's the same quality of audio that you would find in the 1960s. Like that's how, like, you go through a tunnel in the game. Have you done this yet? Where you go through a tunnel and it gets all garbled and it's like but you can still hear it, and then you get, as soon as you leave the tunnel, it's like, and it goes right back to the normal, like, let's go. It goes back to it, and I love that so much because it's real, it's immersive. You get into the tunnel and you're like, God damn it, I'm in a tunnel.
Another addition to that is all the dialogues. Like, even the commercials in between, you can, like, with the voices, how they sound, like, the,
It's got that 60s feel.
Yeah, that one dude that's talking about the French ward all the time, he's, like,
the voice of the Hollow?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then
Remy Duval, the other guy.
Yeah, like, and as you progress through the game, they add more commercials.
Yeah, and they have, like, later on in game, like, you probably haven't gotten there yet, and spoiler, I'll put that at the beginning, probably, just in case there are a bit of spoilers, but it's not really a story spoiler, it's more, like, just really interesting. The space launch happens during the timeline of your game.
Oh, yeah. I've heard about that.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's so cool. The moon landing and shit is going on in the background. I love that.
Oh, and another kind of spoiler-ish one. When you open up the weed racket, you notice the dude talks about how good it is instead of how bad it is as a commercial. And you can actually hear him smoking one in the background.
Yeah. What I like is, for the sound design, it's really, like, immersive. Like, the dialogue is all, like, it's how they would have spoke, it's how they would have acted, and I love that about the game itself, because it feels very, the best word is immersive. Like, it's just, you get into the game.
Yeah, and then, like, if you've ever noticed when you're going over a bump, you can hear all the little metal pieces or, like, glass shifting around. Because, yeah, in the back in the days, the windows weren't as secure as they should have been.
Yeah, and when you start a car, you have that screech noise that almost happens almost every time. Like,
when you turn or a car won't generally start
the two key tries, and the third one always gets it the lucky third time. Yeah, what I like about the story is that you make choices and they have repercussions, like, later on in the game. You can make people mad and stuff at you, it's great. But, for the interactiveness, I think the best part is the option to kill or save the people.
Yeah. It's probably literally the best. And then they have an option in your menus to not murder everybody, you just stop
and
take
them. Right at the beginning of the game, they give you the option, lethal or non-lethal. Mm-hmm. I played two playthroughs, and I played one where I've done that, and the other one, I was lethal. I killed everybody. Mm-hmm. But yeah, there's actually achievements for doing it both ways. So basically, either way, you get an achievement. And heck, there's reasons to go back and do it again, because if you didn't do it one way, or you chose to be that guy who's like, this guy lives, this guy dies, this guy lives, this guy dies, right? And you don't get the achievement, so you gotta go back and play it again. So there's replay value in that.
Yeah, and the stealth or run and gun options.
Yeah, they really balanced
almost
it.
Almost every mission has either stealth it or you can shoot everybody down.
Early game, maybe it's a little more difficult, like, because you have less life, but As long as you know, you're competent at shooting or whatever, then
and it's not tactical about your position, you can literally sit there and just gun everything.
I mean, like, I would say as a sort of con, it's your traditional stealth cover-based shooter. So basically you can either kill people or you can knock them out or whatever you do, and then you just move on and you do your thing systematically. Or, on the other hand, you can just go in like a mobster with your Tommy gun in hand and just blah, 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 you know. And that is, you can do the same thing and say, like, Metal Gear Solid, but they're more geared towards stealth where you have a lot more repercussions, whereas in Mafia, reinforcements will show up. Like, that's about
And this is a literal action shooter game, so you're technically supposed to gun everybody down. But,
yeah,
as you could see in one of my streams, I sure popped the one dude in the head you need to and left.
Classic revenge plot. Like, whereas Mafia 2, to be comparative, was your rise through the ranks of the Italian mob. This one is dismantling that very establishment, but in a different place. The storytelling, like, the way it's told, is in a documentary after the fact, where, you see characters that have, like, definitely gotten through the whole thing, or been through the whole thing.
And you can tell they've been through it because they've aged.
Yeah, like the, preacher. Again, spoiler, but, the priest, he, you can tell he's
destroyed, and also, because he watched, like, his best friend
deteriorate.
And then his orphaned kid go down, you know.
So, but, like, just saying, the only thing I have a problem with is the fact that you saw it coming a mile away. Like, you knew he was going to get double-crossed from the very beginning of the game.
Yeah.
I mean, that's basically how it happens. Oh, another thing to touch on about the choices thing is they basically, to sum it up, it's in the first mission, the very first thing you get to do is decide whether or not you kill a person who is part of your heist or whatever. They were brought in to get you the truck, and then you double-cross them. But I guess the thing I want to touch on there is the fact that it basically points out how you feel like you're going to play the game, because you can either kill that guy and have it be complete, like, done, and you're justified in doing so because, you know, no loose ends or whatever in a criminal organization. But you can also choose to spare him, and it has no repercussions whatsoever. It basically just, it's basically just, you can do, you can don't. And it's basically, it shows you, right at the beginning of the game, who you, quote-unquote, are in the game. Because Lincoln makes a point of being the one to say, we should maybe ice this guy. Lincoln is that guy. He's the guy who's willing to make the tough choices. The characters, the voice actors in real life that they got to play them, whether they did motion cap or not, probably, in this day and age, they almost guaranteed did motion cap for the cutscenes, but fantastic voice acting work. Like, I really believed I was in a New Orleans-esque southern environment.
Yeah, and it's 68.
A little bit corny, like, with the boined and toined and it's hoiting inside, and a little bit over the top, but at the same time, it was like that back in the day. Like, that's how they speak. They still speak to this day that way. So it's very accurate to where they live. So the design, like, for example, Lincoln, before and after you get shot.
Mm-hmm. You can tell.
Like, the gun is, it's the gunshot on his head isn't just a gunshot. It's
to show he's,
it's a physical visual reminder of why he's doing this whole thing. Because they didn't just kill his entire family, they literally killed his entire family and failed to kill him.
Yeah, that scar is just like the scar in the soul, basically.
Yeah.
Or it's been destroyed.
It's a visual representation of the emotional damage, yeah. Mechanics and animations. So this would be under the, like, aesthetics and stuff. Like we talked about before we actually started. It's a nice palette for cars, and it's dulled in the sense that it's a grittier game, so the theme is darker, not brighter, so you're gonna go with darker colors, which actually shows in even the vehicles, because the vehicles only have a set amount of choices, and none of them are exactly what you would call bright. Like, the yellow one is about the brightest one.
Yeah, I was about to say that. But at least, like, reds and they, all the colors were kind of correct, because, like, you're not going to get a lime green or a bright purple back in the day. The dark purple is the closest you're going to get. Even pink was kind of faded back then.
Yep. Oh, the lock picking and whatnot. Like, you can watch that cutscene over and over. You can do the action, the quick time event, over and over, and it never feels too repetitive. Or, in my opinion, exhaustive. Like, you never feel like, oh, I've watched this cutscene a million times, whatever. And that simple design saves you a lot of hassle in the future. Because, say you're playing, like, Skyrim or something, and you're in a dull spell. So you decide to open someone's house, but their master lock takes forever. And then the animation itself, you know, can be taskly to watch and, you know, stuff like that can be really annoying after a time because you've seen it 1,000 times. But in this game, you can do it over and over and over, and in my opinion, and I believe yours as well, it's not repetitive. It doesn't feel too repetitive. And although the sound is lacking, that's not repetitive either. Like, there's a certain amount of soundtrack songs, and they loop, mm-hmm. and they'll keep coming on, but they never feel too repetitive. You can switch over channels and whatnot, and it never feels like you've listened to the loop 100 times. Like, GTA will do that. You'll listen to a station for maybe, like, an hour of game time. And you'll just listen to that station. And it always sounds the same.
Oh, and they made it so that it randomly selects one when you get in the vehicle. Because I've gotten in the same car, like, 5 times, and it's changed between the 3 stations.
Oh, yeah, it always goes back to the last one you were on. For me. Like, it always goes back to W and BX, because that's the one I like to listen to.
Yeah, I was going to say,
always, but for the most part, when I've, like, just gotten out of the car to get another car or something, or have to get another car, it'll go back to the station I was listening to. Like, I've been in the middle of listening to Little Less Conversation, and I had to get out and do something, and then I got into a different car, straight to that station, and I got to listen to the rest of the song. Stuff like that, but not always. In certain cases, it'll switch, like, after a mission, it'll go to a specific channel. Which is also really good sound design, because instead of having the GTA... this is the news on every channel, like, interrupting no matter what, it does it for you, and you can either turn it off and not listen to it, or just listen to it, or just change channel. But it gives you the opportunity to hear it right away.
Oh, yeah, and kind of back to the lockpicking, it's super simple.
Two-step program, done.
A noob could easily complete it. Completely new to games.
And yeah, that's a good thing. It's a very noob-friendly game. Like, you go on easy or medium mode, and... Not that difficult. Plus, they give you the option of the aim assist, which I tried the aim assist just to see what it was like when I went to hard mode. It's not really that great. It's, like, actually more taskly.
Figured as much, most games do that. Mm. They make it worse to have it on.
So, detractors of the game now. We'll go with cons section.
This is kind of a spoiler, but that first mission on the parade, I tried to gun all those police officers. That's fucking impossible.
Yeah, you're supposed to run.
But it doesn't say that.
No, it just leaves you an opening to...
So I died that one time. It took me actually 10 minutes, which is...
Did you get to see... Oh, another plus. Did you get to see the cutscenes for when you lose? There's cutscenes for when you lose. It's great. When you lose... Like, if you're in the boat part when you're getting away in the first mission...
Mm-hmm.
If you accidentally crash or something, that goes back to that old guy, the FBI agent, that talks about it in the documentary, and he's like, that can't be how it happened. And then the game goes, it's over. And then you restart. And there's in the beginning parts, there's a couple of those, because you're supposed to not fail. Mm-hmm. So, like, I've seen them all, because I failed on purpose after I found out about it.
I was going to say, I figure after a certain point, they'd probably take it out, just because you don't want to see it repeatedly.
Oh, once you get to a certain point in the game, you're not getting any more cutscenes. It's basically just because it's, like, a prequel to what you're actually doing. Like, because up until Sammy's death and whatnot, you're basically just playing a prologue that's not actually concurrent.
And what I liked about the prologue part is they switched between what you're currently doing and how they got to the heist.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, you go through the bit of actually getting to the bank, and then it goes back to when you first got back into town. It's a little draggy, like, for story-wise, because you were in the middle of something awesome and actually, and then you're just driving. Mm-hmm. But... at the same time, the setup is perfect for the fact that it feels like you're watching a movie that you are a part of. And that is great.
And most people don't know, but all the 3 underbosses under you are shown in the prologue.
Yeah. in some place or another. Like Cassandra, and they talk about Skeletta, and Burke is the guy with the drill.
Yeah, Cassandra's in that little...
I don't think Vito actually gets seen, but they talk about him, like, three
beforehand,
or four
times. Beforehand, when they're... Then the he leaves before they have the conversation, but when he was going to take over the Hollow, he was there at that, because they were discussing the heist, and he is the one that threw the money in so that they could bring
yeah.
fake money, but it was real money.
Yeah. Alright, we'll move on now. Another con is... This is more your opinion than mine, because I don't really care about the earning system, but the racket design is kind of flawed.
Yeah, you don't earn as much, and you can't really have any, like, involvement in it. Like, yeah, you do a couple... You can do two side missions, and then they give you, like, oh, you can hunt down these cars for them
yeah.
or whatever.
Yeah, and it's basically a set amount of tasks, and then you beat it, and then you beat it. It's beaten. It doesn't repeat. It doesn't do anything else. It's done.
Yeah, and like I said, because you don't earn very much, I figured like you'd be able to invest into like upgrading, like getting bodyguards for your money, like so like Marcano could like maybe invade your things or whatnot, or
yeah, basically do extra stuff.
Upgrade the earnings on it, you know.
Yeah, you can upgrade to a certain point, and once you get to that point, you can't really give anybody extra, otherwise you piss other people off. So. It kind of becomes, you can never reach that ceiling unless you, like, force it. Which means you give them extra and everybody else gets mad at you. But, okay, so yeah. The earning system might need a little bit of a booster in time it takes. That's about it for me. Because it takes a long time to reach that ceiling and then collect the kickback at the top. Like, the ceiling. And that's annoying to me. Even though I'm calling the concierge all the time, it's still annoying that it takes so long to get to the roof of the ceiling of the cap, whatever. Okay, so another pet peeve that's more mine than yours, because
yeah, I kind of enjoy
yeah.
the music.
I hate driving. Like, in both my playthroughs, both my full-length 12-hour playthroughs, that's how long it took me for both of them, 12 hours. I'd say about 4 hours of that was just driving from one place to another. Driving. Even with the upgraded cars and using the upgraded cars 85% to 90% of the time, it still takes forever. And that is frustrating as hell, because that part is the only part of the game that I find repetitive.
Yeah, I know. They make it a little too repetitive for the driving, because you're in and out of a car so much.
I mean,
much
I like
to get
the driving scheme. Don't like the driving scheme is fun, but it's doesn't carry itself. Like, when you're not doing anything other than driving.
And because they designed the car, like, the tires probably to the air, they don't grip the ground immediately, no matter what car
you're Yeah, it leads to some awkward crashes that wouldn't happen if you were, you know, in a different game.
Yeah, like, you slide a lot just because
yeah,
the
tires... Like, the raining. It's, like, things like that were difficult in Mafia 2, but they weren't that bad. But now that they've perfected the mechanics and made it, like, super realistic... It's really taskly to deal with, like, wet roads and stuff.
Yeah, when you're taking over Tikva Harbor, it's raining 90% of
the
time,
like
the
whole
time, yeah. And you're crashing into stuff.
And this happened to me more than him, but we are downloadable gamers. We download the games because we don't want to deal with the CD, usually. Well, I mean, we will get the CD if the CD is, like, on sale, and it's like, sweet deals. But for the most part, we will DLC and do the same thing, usually wait for the sale and then be like, sweet deals. But, but for the most part, my issue is that sometimes there's colliders that'll glitch you, or non-visible colliders, like you'll blow something up and there'll be like stacks of money still floating.
Fly, of course.
Fly?
And other times, the stacks of money will physically just fall to the ground. So you know they're supposed to fall if you destroy the table, or whatever they're sitting on, but they don't. And that can be a bit...
They didn't really...
Takes me out of it, the experience, a little bit. Because it's like, that can't happen. That's for sure. I did a barrel roll over 4 different Mafia guys in my car, landed, sniped one of them, got out of my car, and then proceeded to stab the other guy in the face from, like, running 15 feet at him, taking bullets the whole way. So I'm okay to bend the rules on realism. Like, none of that's going to happen in real life, and you're going to get out of it without a scratch.
But regardless of how OP you are, money should not float.
Shit just shouldn't float. That's not how it works. So that's my biggest pet peeve. That and, I guess because of a downloading glitch, because I copied it from his external hard drive, it crashes every once in a while. I mean, it stopped happening after the first playthrough or so, but my first playthrough, every 3-4 hours, or after specific parts in the game even, for both playthroughs, it would just crash and send me back to the home, which, that's more of an interface issue, less a game issue, but still, it's annoying, because you can be just finishing a mission, or just starting a mission, and it'll crash, and it's annoying. Super annoying. Okay, but I think we've covered pretty much everything about this game that bugs us, so...
Yeah, pretty much.
Anything else? Outlying thoughts?
I was gonna say maybe too many guys with shotguns and snipers.
Yeah, a lot the of shotgun mission. People. And their shotguns hurt you really bad from 15, 20 feet away, but your shotguns don't do the same amount of damage.
I felt a great disturbance in the force.
I hate when they do that. It's an unfair balance for the NPCs.
Yeah, like this one mission, I swear to God, every dude had either a sniper or a shotgun, so yeah. I couldn't get close and I couldn't be far away.
I think that's how they did the difficulty curve.
No! Not the face!
Like, more shotguns and more snipers, because they have the heavy damagers. I assume that's how they did it, because they start popping up everywhere. All the time.
Probably more likely that they would.
But yeah, so overall, what would you rate this out of, if we could only give it 5? Because that's what I usually do my systems, 1 to 5.
I would say 5 just simply in the fact that if you're looking for an action mobster game, it's perfect.
Yeah, that's like, true. I mean, I absolutely loved Mafia 2. It was so much fun. The collectibles were fun. Like, everything about that game was fun. Mafia 3, basic same deal, but you get to, like I said, there's a moral gray area where Lincoln is justified in killing a lot of the people he kills, but at the same time, you watch him descend into a...
Just
he becomes the thing he's killing. Like, you hear throughout the story of Sal's actions as he was taken over the city. He literally took over the city, basically the same way Lincoln did, except with more men. Mm-hmm. And more connections. Lincoln just does it by himself, with a few people, which is awesome. But yeah, choices are probably the best thing.
Oh yeah.
In any game, especially when your choices have weight, when they matter.
Yeah, like the rackets when you're recruiting dudes. It might not be that big of a weight, but doing like those missions where you have to collect up the random cars that are driving around, that would take forever to fill up the bars if you didn't recruit every single dude type thing. If you're just going around killing them all, you'd have to do a lot of
stuff. Yeah, to raise that ceiling, you basically have to turn and flip pretty much everyone to get to like the highest you can without cheat or screwing over a different boss. But yeah, so overall, he says 5, and I'm gonna be the skeptic and say 4. Because I did have a few experiences with the game that were a little bit... Or 4.5 out of 5 for Mafia 3. Go get the game. Play it for yourself. It's fantastic. It's super immersive. And that's pretty much all you can say. And that's pretty much it for the game review, Mafia 3. Like I was saying, go out and get it. For sure.
And definitely worth the money.
Oh, yeah. We got it on sale, but it's probably worth full package price, like 60, 70 bucks. It's worth it.
Yeah, so. I would definitely agree to that.
Yeah. So this has been Clouded in the Snail Mail, and this has been a review of Mafia 3. Like, share, and subscribe. I don't know. That's pretty much all you can do. Alrighty, have a good one.
Don't get old, son. It's a fucking shit show.
No soup for you!